Let me come before this word very quickly. Very quickly. Again. Now Paul says, again I tell to you. Right? When Paul writes his epistle, you might have come across, you know, when he is writing his epistle, he is telling, again I write to you. Again I say this to you. And this morning, again I am speaking from this particular passage. Praise God. Let us come before the presence of God with a receptive heart and mind. And telling to God that God speak to me. हम परमेश्वर की उपस्थिति में एक धन्यवादित हृदय के साथ में हम परमेश्वर के सामने बोले, परमेश्वर मैं ये स्वीकार करने के लिए तैयार हूँ, तू मुझसे बातें कर। जरूर परमेश्वर हमसे आज सुबह बातें करने के लिए योग्य परमेश्वर है। यहाँ एक दृष्टांत हम देखते हैं, प्रभु यीशु मसीह एक दृष्टांत बता रहा है। जीसस इज शेयरिंग ए स्टोरी, ए पैराबल। यू नो व्हाट इज अ पैराबल? अगेन एंड अगेन आई एम आस्किंग, व्हाट इज अ पैराबल? Earthly story with heavenly meaning. Earthly story with heavenly meaning. Jesus, during his ministry time, whenever he teaches something, if the teaching is little bit complicated, it is difficult for the people to understand, he always used parable. The parable which was existing during his time. Right? In every home, there is a narration of this story. The father used to, mother used to share this story to the children. Even the rabbinic teacher, the Jewish rabbis in the synagogues, when they teach, they used to share these stories. And Jesus was collecting all those stories and keeping in his mind. And whenever he teach about the kingdom of God, jab bhi parmeshwar ki rajya ke bare mein jab khulasa karta hai, Prabhu Yeshu Masih uske support ke liye, sachi achhi tarah se samajh mein aane ke liye, he used to use this parable. He used to use this parable. And here, Jesus is again using this parable because he was teaching something. What he was teaching? Prayer. What he was teaching? Prayer. Prayer. So when you read Luke chapter 11, verse number 1, it says, one day Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray just as John taught his disciples. One of the disciples of Jesus is coming to Jesus and asking Jesus, Lord, teach us to pray. Hame prarthna karne ke liye sikha. You know, John, you know, who had come just before you, he has many disciples, and we were once upon a time in the group of John's disciples, and we have learned some prayer from John. John is teaching that to his disciples. Why don't you teach us? Praise God. Till now, no, the disciples were just walking with Jesus. They were seeing the miracles happening. They are hearing to the teachings of Jesus. They are listening to the kingdom of God's principles. No, they are coming to know about what is the reality of the kingdom of God. All those things are happening, but they have till now not learned how to pray. Praise God. Prarthna karne abhi tak sikha nahi. आज सुबह हमारी गाना भी वही था, इट वॉज अ लॉर्ड्स प्रेयर। थैंक यू ब्रदर, आई डोंट नो व्हाई ही सेड दैट, एंड दैट वॉज द टाइम गॉड वॉज स्पीकिंग टू मी। आमेन। द लॉर्ड्स प्रेयर, समटाइम्स वी थिंक, यू नो, व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ लॉर्ड्स प्रेयर? नो, सम एक्सट्रीमिस्ट क्रिश्चियंस आर देयर हु विल से दैट नो नीड ऑफ लॉर्ड्स प्रेयर, वी हैव आवर प्रेयर इन अवर माउथ, विद द स्पिरिट वी कैन प्रे। यस, वी कैन प्रे इन स्पिरिट, बट देयर इज मच इंपॉर्टेंस इन द प्रेयर विच जीसस ऑल्सो टॉट। We should understand that, right? And Jesus taught this to reveal something about God to the disciple. Who really the God is? कौन है जीवित परमेश्वर? Right? आज सुबह हम थोड़ी बात को देखेंगे समझने के लिए कि जब हम प्रार्थना करते हैं, क्या हम reality में सोचते हैं कि कौन है परमेश्वर? Who is God? Now Jesus, when he teaches the prayer, he is revealing something. He is unfolding the nature of God, the characteristics of God. Parameshwar ka swabhav ko yahan par khulasa kar raha. He is trying to reveal it to the disciples, telling that you should not pray just like other pagans used to pray. You know, Matthew chapter 6, when you read, there is a good narration about it. Go home and read it. I have no time to again explore into that. But Jesus' emphasis was that you should not pray as you were praying in the Jewish religious system. Don't pray like the religious people, but pray as if like having a greater relationship with God. Amen. हमारी प्रार्थना कैसी होनी चाहिए? हमारी प्रार्थना एक रिश्ते में बंद करके होने चाहिए। हमें रिश्ते के बंधन में आकर के हमें परमेश्वर से प्रार्थना करना चाहिए। Amen. क्या आप मेरे साथ में हैं? Is everyone is with me? Brother, you understand Hindi? No, okay, okay. I will tell you in English also. Praise God. Here Jesus is teaching prayer, right? When he's teaching the prayer, his focus is the disciples should understand who God is. Now let's come to the verse number 2. He says, when you pray that Father. Now Luke recites this prayer very quickly. It's in a very shortened way. But in Matthew, when you read, now this morning we have read that. In Matthew it was our Father. Right? Our Father. Right? So Jesus is teaching his disciples, telling that when you pray in this way, our Father. So God, when you look to God, you should look to God in a father figure. Amen? Who is God? God is just like a father figure. Right? So God's personality, Jesus is revealing. What God is revealing? God's personality. एक व्यक्तित्व को वहां पर खुलासा कर रहा है प्रभु यीशु मसीह. बोल रहा है जब भी तुम प्रार्थना करो तो इस प्रकार से प्रार्थना करो, हमारे स्वर्गीय पिता परमेश्वर. प्रेज गॉड. राइट? हमारे. नो, इट्स नॉट जस्ट ए सिंगुलर. राइट? इट्स नॉट जस्ट सिंगुलर, बट देयर इज ए प्लुरैलिटी वी कुड सी. देयर इज ए इंक्लूसिव नेचर वी कैन सी. राइट? जीसस इज आस्किंग हिज डिसिपल्स, व्हेन यू प्रे इंक्लूड अदर्स ऑल्सो. Don't go for selfish prayer. Amen. Amen. When we come to prayer, our intention is not that I should get everything. But when I am asking for myself, it's not myself. Whosoever is surrounded around me, they must also get whatever I am asking. Hello? Praise God. Are you getting? Praise God. That is a Christian prayer. Christian prayer is not a selfish prayer. That's why Jesus, when he's teaching the disciple, he's telling you pray our Father. So we are in a community. We are in an assembly of God. We are come as from the different places and joined in one room glorifying to God. And when I pray that, Lord, this is my need, I am praying in my heart that when you fulfill my need, I want my brothers and sisters' needs should be also fulfilled. Amen. Praise God. Our Father. Here we could see God's personality has been revealed. When you come to that second, the continuation of that prayer. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Right? The prayer is your kingdom come and your will be done. First is God's personality. Second is God's purpose. Jesus is revealing God's purpose. In the prayer, when we pray, we should also acknowledge the purpose of God. Why I am praying to God, right? I am praying to God because I want God's kingdom to come on this earth. Hallelujah. जब मैं प्रार्थना करता हूं, परमेश्वर का राज्य मेरे मध्य में उतर के आना है. जब उसका राज्य उतर के आ रहा है, उसका will भी होना है. When his kingdom comes, his will also should be done. Amen. तो हमारी प्रार्थना कैसे है? हमारी प्रार्थना में हम पर्सनैलिटी, एक फादर फिगर से हम प्रार्थना कर रहे हैं. जैसे हम पिता के पास में बिना शर्माते हुए, विदाउट एनी शेम, बोल्डनेसली वी कम एंड आस्क, वी शुड ऑल्सो अप्रोच गॉड एंड वी जस्ट पोर आउट एज ए चाइल्ड पोर आउट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ हिज ओन फादर. आमेन. प्रेज गॉड. सेकेंड इज हिज पर्पस. लॉर्ड, आई वॉन्ट योर पर्पस टू बी डन. I am praying to you. There is my, some intentions are there. My will is there. But more than my will, I want your will to be done. See, that is how Jesus is teaching the disciples. The prayer. When I pray, it's not my will, Lord, but your will be done. Your kingdom be coming over there. We know this kingdom. This kingdom is under the rule of the evil one. You know, we read in 1 John chapter 5. Shall we take 1 John chapter 5, verse number 19. 1 John chapter 5, verse number 19, please, quickly.
We know that
yeah.
we are children of God
yeah.
and that the whole world is under the control of the evil one.
The whole world is under the control of? Hello, please speak out. Under the control of? Evil one. Right? We are the children of God, but this whole world is under the control of evil one. That's why everywhere evil is there. Right? Everywhere. There is no place where there is no evil. Everywhere, at any moment of time, the evil can happen. But in this evil world, God has placed us as children of God. As children of God, when I pray, my priority is that, Lord, your kingdom come, your will be done. Praise God. This morning, how is our prayer? Are we praying that, God, let your kingdom come, let your will be done? Amen? That should be the prayer. So here in the Lord's prayer, first God's personality, second God's purpose, third we see God's provision when he is teaching them, give us each day our daily bread. Give us each day our daily bread. Har din ki roti tum mujhe dena. So here Jesus is teaching disciples, when you pray this, you are telling God is a provider. There is a God's provision is there. Amen. God's provision is there, so I can come and ask. Now Jesus is not teaching that you should pray, give us for 30 days our daily bread. Give us for 1 year our daily bread. Right? Jesus is not teaching that. How Jesus is teaching? Daily. What we understand, our prayer must be daily. Hello? Our prayer must be daily. It's not just Sunday. Yes, we are coming together and we are worshiping, we are praising, we are adoring God, we are praying, we are listening to the word. That's not enough. Disciples, try to understand this. When you asked me how to pray, let me tell you, the prayer should be daily. When Jesus said that you should pray daily, he was praying daily. Amen? We know the prayer of Jesus, right? How was the prayer of Jesus? Every day when he starts the ministry, but before that, he used to spend time in the presence of God. Mark chapter 1 verse 35 onwards, we read that when he started his public ministry, he was in Peter's home and Peter's mother-in-law was sick over there and he healed Peter's mother-in-law. And at night, the different miracles and wonders and Lord, the devils were casted out. But when the dawn broke, the next morning, early in the morning, he was away in the wilderness. He was in the desert. Place praying to the heavenly Father. Amen. Praise God. So every day when he begins his ministry, he was not just simply beginning the ministry, but there was a backing of prayer. Amen. So daily he was involved in prayer, and he wants his disciples who is following Jesus should pray daily and should ask God, forgive us today our daily bread. Amen. He is the provider of all our needs. Amen. He's the provider God. He has got all the provisions. Praise God. There is no lacking over there. But what we have to do, we have to ask. We have to ask. What is prayer? Asking to God. Pouring out our soul in the presence of God. And Jesus wants that. You pour out your soul to your heavenly Father. God's person, God's purpose, God's provision. And number four, we see, you know, Jesus is teaching, forgive us our sin. Forgive us our sin. God's pardon. God is a God who pardons us, who forgives us. Right? When you come in prayer, you are living in this world. There will be some sins. There will be something wrongdoing. There will be some iniquities. There will be something immorality that had crept into your life. But when you come before God, you should understand our God is a God who pardons. God hates sin but loves the sinner. Amen. Jesus was the friend of sinners. Praise God. Hallelujah. In his WhatsApp group, who were their friends? Sinners. Praise God. I'm just applying that. When we look to our WhatsApp contact, we can understand who are our friends. Praise God. And Jesus was acknowledged as, the people used to say that he is the friend of sinners, but not to sin again. When a sinner comes to Jesus, that person from the sinner state, she has been converted to saint. Sinner converting to saint. Ek papi vyakti, ek pavitra vyakti mein badal jana. Praise God. Jesus ke paas jo bhi aata hai, when he gives pardon, he is no more sinner, but he has come to an upgradation in his life. And that upgradation is, you are a saint. Amen. Amen. We are in the assembly of saints today. Can you say that? You should be able to say. Why you know? Because our God is a God who pardons. This is the result. Today we are commemorating this. It is only because Jesus took the sin on his shoulder and died on the cross. He had no sin within himself, but he carried, he took the sin of the humanity, the God becoming flesh and dying for the humanity, telling and revealing that our God is a God who can pardon every sins. Amen. But what we have to do, we have to confess. We have to confess. That's why in the prayer is, forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone who sins against us. Lord, forgive us our sins. Let that be the prayer when we are hearing to Lord's prayer this morning. Lord, forgive us our sins. We pray the beautiful song that we have sang at the beginning of the worship this morning. Praise God. Forgive us our sins. I pray, Lord. Hallelujah. I want everyone, those who have been born in a having the born again experience, those who have taken received the commandment of Jesus Christ, who has taken water baptism, the immersion water baptism, this morning you should also pray within yourself, in your heart, in your mind, Lord, forgive my sins, Lord. Forgive my sins, because we have a God who can pardon. Praise God. And finally, he ends the prayer telling that, do not lead us into temptation and deliver us from all evil one. From all evil. Do not lead us into temptation. And then deliver us from all evil. God's protection. God's protection. Jesus is telling, there is a protector God. God is a God who protects us. Amen. God is a God who protects us. We have seen 5 P's over here. God's personality, God's purpose, God's provision, God's pardon, God's protection. Amen. This prayer is teaching us who God is. Amen. Hallelujah. Now how much meaning it is when we recite this. Hallelujah. This prayer is talking about who God is. God can do anything for you when you pray, but you should know that you are a child of God. Aapko kya bolna hai? Main Parmeshwar ka bachcha hoon. Main Parmeshwar ka santan hoon. Main Parmeshwar ka beta hoon. Main Parmeshwar ka beti hoon. Main apne pita ke paas mein jab bhi aaunga, kis prakar se pukarunga? Abba. Right? Abba. Let that come out from our heart. Abba. Hey pita. Praise God. Let our prayer be in that model. Amen. Let our prayer be in that model. And then after that, Jesus is teaching a parable. With a parable, he is explaining. He is giving a light. He is giving an emphasis on prayer. How to pray. What to pray. The importance of prayer. The every aspects of the prayer we can get by reading this wonderful parable. Right? This is a story about a person. Right, in a house, at midnight, a friend comes. Right? An unexpected time. In an unexpected moment, the friend is appearing. Now what Jesus wants to explain from this wonderful parable, that in human beings' life, at any moment of time, unexpected crisis can come, just like a guest comes at the midnight to our house. Without prior information. Right? Without prior information. Here, without prior information, a person is coming, a friend is coming to another friend's house. And when he opens the door, he finds his friend and he is in pain. What is his pain? He cannot show the hospitality. This house has nothing to give to this particular guest. And this guest is hungry. He wants some food. But he came to his friend's house where there is no food. The food has been over. रात को 9 बजे बच्चे पति पत्नी सब खाना खा करके खत्म करके सो गए. सोचेंगे कल के दिन में, हम कल के बारे में सोचेंगे. उनका आज का दिन खत्म हो चुका है, लेकिन उनका फ्रेंड जो आ रहा है उसके लिए दिन खत्म नहीं हुआ. उसका रात का खाना बाकी है, और जिसका रात का खाना बाकी है आके खटखटा रहा है. जब दरवाजा खोला ये अंदर गया, लेकिन यहां पर उसको खाने के लिए नहीं है कुछ. Now this friend, who is now confused what to do, he remembers, oh, I have another friend in my neighborhood. Amen. Mere padosh mein mera aur ek friend hai. Hallelujah. और वो उसके पास में जा रहा है, खटखटा रहा है, और वहां पर हम पढ़ते हैं शेमलेस ऑडेसिटी वो दिखा रहा है ना, बिना किसी शर्म के साथ में वो खटखटा रहा है, बैंग बैंग बैंग, अंदर से आवाज आया हम नहीं खोल सकते, मेरे बच्चे मेरे साथ में, मुझे परेशान मत कर यार, तू चला जा. But he is not ready to listen to that. He is again, no, bang, bang, bang. Kholna hi padega. You have to open. Because this friend knows that he is my best friend. Even if I will disturb him at this middle of the night, tomorrow morning when I will see him and when I say, hello, friend, he will be smilingly, he will reply, hi. He knows that. That's why shamelessly he is banging at the door. And what this person, the story ends in this way. This person opens the door and he, that other friend, gets inside and he tells that whatever you need, you take it. How much you need, you take it and go and show the hospitality to your friend. What is the crux of the story? What is the message that we get? Let me go quickly and tell you that that the real meaning, what God, what Jesus want to explain to the disciple. Jesus want to say, do you have a friend? Do you have a friend? You said, I have taught you that God is a father. But I am your master. The Savior is a friend of you. Praise God. You know, in the Gospel according to John, Jesus at the end of the ministry, when he calls his disciples, he says, friends. Praise God. Friends, not servants, but friends. He's a master. But the master calling the disciples, friends, this morning, is Jesus is our friend? Hallelujah. Kya Yeshu kya mera dost hai? Praise God. If Jesus is your friend, in this life, there can be unexpected crisis. Just like the guest, crisis can come. Our calculation can go wrong. Our planning can go wrong. Today you are sitting over here with a great plan. Next day, what you're going to do? But Jesus is telling one thing. Friends, your planning can go wrong. Your calculation can go wrong. But when you go through such crisis situations in your life, remember, there is a friend. There is a friend to whom you can approach. When Jesus is teaching this prayer, he's telling that this prayer is not for a particular moment of time, but at any time, in whichever the situations you will be, you have got the access to come to this friend. Not in a religious way, but in a way of relationship. In a way of relationship. Relate with God. Relate with God. He is not somebody who is too far. He is just close to us. At the distance of a word. Abba. Abba. Praise God. Whatever may be your struggles. Your calculations have gone wrong. Your plannings have been distorted. You are in a hopeless situation. You don't know tomorrow in your professional life what is going to happen. Though you have a greater plans in your career, tomorrow, if that calculation has gone wrong, this is the message which Christ wants to give to you this morning. You have got a friend. Hallelujah. Approach him. Praise God. How do we respond? When we go through crisis, when we go through unexpected crisis, how do we respond? Is my first response is going and telling to my wife, I am mistaken. If my first response is going and telling to my brother, I am mistaken. Is my first response is going and revealing this unexpected crisis to my parents, I am somewhere wrong. Hallelujah. Tell to Jesus, your best friend. This is the teaching. Amen. Then Jesus says, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open unto you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If this is the word of Jesus, Praise God. This has been fulfilling since last 2,000 years. Amen. Bible is the witness of that. We who have been gathered over here is the witness of that. Hallelujah. If I give you an opportunity to give the testimony, your testimony will be there that when I went through my troubles time, I called upon my Lord and God came and delivered me from all the trouble. Yes or no? Praise God. Yes, hallelujah. That's why this morning, on the first day of the week, we have gathered over here to celebrate unto the Lord Jesus Christ, the risen Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Praise God. There is a reason why we have gathered over here. Praise God. We work 6 days, but one day is the holy day. But when our friends are rejoicing at home, relaxing at home, and you know, and is celebrating their life, we are giving our life to our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 One of my friends asked me, why you go to Sunday? Why you go to church on Sunday? You should have taken rest. We are doing rest. We are washing our clothes. We are doing all the household things. Praise God. Now sometimes that can hit us. Right? We may be thinking of taking a break on Sunday. Praise God. But our priority should be giving our life to the Lord. Because this life is not ours. This life belongs to God. That knowledge we have come into. Praise God. Amen. 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 We have a friend. And that friend died for us. That friend taught us something, how to live. And after teaching how to live, he died for us. He died for our sins. And those who have received him have got the right to be called as children of God. This morning, whoever has received Christ Jesus, you are the child of God. You are the child of God. And you have got the right. You have got the access to approach him shamelessly. Hallelujah. Take away your mask. Praise God. Take away your mask. I am what I am inside. Show it to the Father. And Father is ready to receive us. Praise God. We are going to commemorate the Lord's table. Praise God. Many more things to say, but I will stop over here.